Welcome everybody to NPWA Pro Wrestling. The world is watching us. And they're watching you.
And unfortunately you too.
Gorgeous Gary Johnson to my right. I'm Bill Bronson, and we're here today with some great wrestling action as only the NPWA can provide for you fans. The final vote for the votes that the fans out there participated in last season is the worst wrestler of the year, and we're going to find out who that is this week. We found out who the wrestler of the year was. It was Hot Body Brown. The tag team of the year was the Wild Things.
No surprises here.
The most popular wrestler of the year was the Ultimate Champ, and the most hated wrestler of the year was the Bad Boy, who we haven't seen yet this season in the NPWA, but he'll be around, rest assured. But this week we're going to see who the worst wrestler of the year is. Not really an award that I would want to win if I was a wrestler. That's nothing to be proud of.
No.
Well, maybe it is.
Maybe. Well, like I said, no surprises so far with the most hated, the best wrestler and the best tag team. But with the most popular wrestler, I mean, I guess the Planet of the Apes must have voted on this one, because how anybody can like the Ultimate Champ, because, I mean, the man just, he tries to. He's an overachiever. I'll give him that he gets in the ring, he fights hard, but he just cannot do anything besides beat low-level opponents. When he gets up there in that title shot, he just loses it all the time.
You know, they ought to paint like a racing stripe down your tongue, because that's all you do is talk so fast, and you don't know what you're saying. You're making things about the Ultimate Champ. He is the most popular wrestler of the year, and that has happened. The fans voted for it. It is a fact. You have no say about that.
I guess not. I didn't know we had so many idiots out there voting.
Calling our fans idiots?
Well, the ones that voted for the Ultimate Champ, yeah. All five of them. I guess six people wrote in.
Oh, come on.
I don't know.
The votes are up there, believe me. But we're going to find out that. And also, let's get on with the rest of the show. We're going to have the Rockin' Rebel in action. He'll be meeting Jerry Curl. Scott Oresko is going to have a special report. He did go to the Shaolin Temple. I don't even know what it is. It must be in the Orient or something.
I don't even know what a Shaolin Temple is.
We'll find out about that this week with the new wrestler of the NPWA. And we're also going to have an update on the tag team title situation. Is Tom the G and the Headbanger, are they going to show up this week? Are they going to pay the fine? Are they going to emerge as champions? What's going to happen? Did you call Tom the G? What's the update?
I talked to Tom the G and I talked to the Headbanger. And right now,
what'd they tell
you? There's no telling what's going to happen. Tom the G, I said he's very upset. I said, you know, look, I'll pay this $1,000 fine. He says he's not going to come back to the commissioner's gone. And,
What do you have against the commissioner?
He doesn't like him.
Oh, so you don't like the commissioner, therefore you don't return to the NPWA?
When you're used to running things your way.
You're a tag team champion.
When you're used to running things your way, like he did last year, and you're used to getting your things done your way, and some guy comes in who's virtually invisible all year long and it says things are going to be different, it's bound to upset a man like Tom Legini.
Him and the commissioner did have a lot of animosity last year, but we never got to see the commissioner.
I wish we could never get to see the commissioner.
Well, let's go and see this man right now. The Ultimate Champ, he'll be in action moments from now against the Bank Robber. So let's go down to ringside and see the Ultimate Champ in action.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from New Haven, Connecticut, weighing 200 pounds,
the Bank
Robber.
The Bank Robber, again, here in the NPWA. And boy, oh boy, I'll tell you, he might be good at robbing banks, but he's not great in the ring, I'll tell you that much.
I'd wear a penny above my head, too, if I were this wrestler.
Alberta, Canada. Weighing 240 pounds, the Ultimate Champ!
All right. There he is. Looks like he's getting a chuckle out of this guy.
I think what it is nobody's going to be able to beat this guy. Can't be anybody else. Oh,
Roberto Eric, our referee today.
Great shorts, Roberto.
Just for this matchup.
Multiple champs going right up to the bank robber. Choke him. That's a ring. Come on, ref. Give me a count. Yeah, I can't believe you're going to choke the bank robber.
Big splash. Ultimate champ. Jumping down on the bank robber. Now he's got the leg.
Scott Reagan, he's getting ready for his finishing maneuver there.
Oh my God!
Sydney, the sharpshooter. Ultimate Champ is good at working on the legs. He's a leg wrestler, so to speak.
Well, not a bad to say about the Ultimate Champ. He has kept his shape over the break during the first season to this season now, and he looks finer than ever this season.
He does. He looks like he's been spending a little more time in the technical department as well.
Yes.
Very improved wrestler.
Yes, but he still has a very hairy chest. We'll see what comes this year for the Ultimate Champ. Perhaps the title.
Perhaps. I wouldn't worry about if he has a hairy chest or not. I don't think you're much better there, Gorgeous Gary.
The atomic knee lift there. Let's call the action here.
Oh, now you don't want to talk about that, huh?
Well, as you can see here,
clothesline.
Ultimate Champ is on fire in this match.
Tell you, Gorgeous Gary, how much would they have to pay you to go wear pantyhose on your head inside a wrestling ring?
Well, it really depends, you know. I mean, I couldn't sell myself short for the money, but you never know, how maybe the bank robber is really ugly or something, you know. I mean,
think this man's really a bank robber or what?
It's possible he could be wanted by the FBI. That's possibly why he's wearing a pantyhose.
I hope the FBI don't
maybe
read
he just gets a cheap
room.
Throw out of it. I don't know. Whatever it is, he just can't wrestle. He's losing this match pretty damn well. And Ultimate Champ, I think, has it pretty much in hand.
Timeout.
Timeout. This is wrestling. There's no timeout in wrestling.
If he was robbing a bank, I don't think he'd call timeout.
I don't think he's very, very good at robbing a bank either. Looks like he's shaking him up here.
Ultimate Champ now, what's he gonna do with the bank robber?
He lets him down easy, drops him, but he let him down easy.
He's letting him pay, I think.
Yeah, I think he's making him think about what he's gonna do next.
Ultimate Champ now setting up the bank robber. Steps behind, Ned.
A neck twist of some sort there, and the bank robber is down. And Eric, I think this is it.
He
can stick a fork in this one. He's done.
All right, sharpshooter. That's what he calls it. Oh, the bank robber. I heard it from here. He conceded.
Here is your winner, the Ultimate Champ.
All right. We're about ready to go to the update. Find out.
Fans, this is the most happiest week of my life. Welcome to NPWA Update. I'm Scott Oresco. Well, they are fools, fans. I've never seen such a foolish tag team in all my life. The Wild Things are now the former tag team champions. Who did they lose to? Themselves! Themselves, fans. This team had 3 weeks to defend their titles. Tamaji, as you know, was suspended. He hit first interfering in Superstar Show on 2 in 2 matches. He had to pay a $1,000 fine. He did not do that. Todd Peter said, well, he wanted to hold a meeting with him and get this thing settled, pay your fine, and get back in the ring. Tom the G. No one has heard from the man. We've seen the headbanger wrestle singly. He has no comment about Tom the G. Well, they waited and they waited. We tried. And Commissioner Peters can't take it anymore. Hey, the Wild Things are now stripped. There are no tag team champions right now in the NPWA. I would love to see what Tom the G and the Headbanger have to say about this, but we're trying to get some words with them, but we can't get a hold of them. We've had our porters going to their house, banging on their door, but they will not. No one answering the door. I don't even know if Tom the G is even in the United States right now. Who knows where the man is? He has not been seen this season so far in the NPWA. We've seen the Headbanger. All I can say is the Wild Things are done. I mean, we have not seen this team wrestle at all this year. And for all you fans who don't remember the Wild Things, let's take you back right now. Their last match as a tag team and as tag team champions. I always forget that team who they faced. I think we showed this clip a couple weeks back, but just for you fans out there to remember who this team was, I think you'll know the reason why this team. I think I know why this team is gone from the NPWA. Let's take a look. You'll know why after you see this clip. Roll it.
Oh, he throws him out. Was there a tag? Was there a tag? I didn't see no tag.
There was a tag.
Scott Oresco. Oh. DDT. It's over. Pin him, Tom. Pin him.
I've never seen the champions like this. They are so aggressive.
Eyes over there.
Referee, not
oh, no.
Referee just went down from the impact of... Oh!
Scott's big head.
From behind because the referee went down. Look at this. What's going to happen now? Referee's out of it. Man of Steel.
Man of Steel. Get out of there. You are not the legal man.
No. The legal men are Tom the G and Scott Oresco. Oh, wait a second.
Here we go. All right, Rampage. Smart.
No!
Oh, no. Rampage, what is wrong with you? Oh, Rampage, you stupid idiot.
He's they not give a you, stupid
they
idiot.
They give you a second chance. I think he did it on purpose. I think he did it on purpose.
Scott Oresco just went across the ring.
No! No! That's it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
God, no.
The winners.
Watch what happens here. I guarantee you. Rampage will pay for this training.
Oresco!
As you can see, fans, it all makes sense. The Wild Things could not take their first defeat ever to the hands of myself and the Man of Steel. That's why I think they're gone. Tom the G could never face up to it. His defeat to me was the most embarrassing thing in his life, probably. Well, I'm just happy. That's all I can have to say, fans. Anyway, now that there's no tag team champions, hopefully no word yet on an upcoming tournament. Hopefully Commissioner Pierce will be working on that. But Commissioner Pierce is working on a new title coming into the NPWA, a tournament for the Connecticut State Championship. More word on that in the next few weeks, fans, so you do not want to miss that. So, for update, I'm Scott Oresco, and I will see you next week.